by Hello.
That's like an hour of this game. So I'm gonna go to Ten Snake and just unlock Ten Snake stuff. Sure. I'm gonna do the parry, I guess, why not? I really don't swap styles, it's not my type of thing. There's no strike to parries during XP boost. Move. Grab enemy if they're on the ground. Oh, and you're on the ground. As the fright increases. But throw while EX boost is active. That would have been pretty good actually.
Wait a minute, what?
Yo, you took your sweet time, but I got the gist of it. You're going to Ijincho, right? To meet with Sawa-sensei?
Kaito-san, you do realize that only I can meet her. You can't get into the school.
I know, but if you end up taking it off campus, can you at least call me this time?
Don't you understand the situation? Sawa-sensei might be tied to murder.
You sure you understand it? Come on, she would never do that.
That a fact?
So happens I'm a great judge of character. Especially when it comes to women.
Sometimes I forget who I'm talking to.
Okay. Pet the cab. Go to Ijinjo. I can do that. But actually, that's not over here.
First stop, it's gotta be Chinatown. Can't face Tsukumo on an empty stomach.
Never a dull day for you, huh, Kaito-san?
It's a selection, man. I've already worked out the math. I figure if I hit 4 or 5 places a day...
What? What's up?
Check that out. It's Akutsu.
Kamurocho thugs are looking pretty out of place here.
Yo! Akutsu! What are you fools doing in town? Hey, don't ignore me. It's Kaito. Fancy seeing you here.
I'm kind of busy here, man. Catch you later.
What an asshole. Ichincho's a long way from home. And he's traveling with a small army.
Would he have come all this way because of us?
Nah, we just caught him totally off guard. He's not out here for us. Gotta be something else.
But something's not right if they're just cruising around. It's gotta be an RK operation. He brought too many guys for it to be something more personal.
Yeah. Kamurocho's streets can be tough. Maybe they gave up. Well... whatever they came out here to do, we ought to keep our noses the hell out of their business. But you better hustle. You're gonna be late for class. I'll catch you after school.
Oh. What is it, Yagami-san?
Sensei, do you have a minute?
I saw the video of Mikoshiba-kun.
So you did. That video, right?
I thought Ehara-san was convicted for a sex offense. How could he be in that video killing Mikoshiba-kun? But then that video looked so real.
Most likely it is. As you unfortunately had to witness, Ehara-san committed murder with his own two hands. Which means as far as the groping that day goes, there's some deception at work.
Deception?
Are you familiar with Ehara-san's victim in the case? Her name is Yui Mamiya.
I don't think I recognized her, no.
13 years ago, she attended Kurokawa Academy. Her maiden name is Yui Suzuki.
Yui Suzuki? Just a minute. Are you saying she was the one Ehara-san groped?
So you do know her then? Were you two classmates?
We were, in our third year of high school.
I had a hunch. You didn't know she was the victim of that whole incident?
I mean, it's just so hard to believe.
Does this all seem like a wild coincidence to you then? Your old student's father gropes one of your high school classmates at a station with 3 million daily travelers.
What are you implying?
I'm saying your old friend Yui might be cooperating with Ehara-san, as in she only played the part of a victim. She might have even known it was all to hide a murder.
What? But why? Why would she do that for him?
From where I'm sitting, Sensei, you're connected to Ehara and Yui Mamiya. I just need your help figuring out what that connection is.
Yagami-san, please. Are you implying I was some kind of liaison between them?
Well, Sensei, what was your relationship with Yui Mamiya? Were you close? Or would you say classmates covers it?
The two of us were never really that close. To be honest, I didn't really like the group of kids she hung out with. I guess you could say we didn't have the same interests.
When was the last time you saw her? Did you have a high school reunion by any chance?
They held a reunion around the time I graduated from college. But I didn't feel like going. That same class bullied a kid into jumping off the roof.
So if that's the case, you haven't seen any of your classmates since you all graduated from Kurokawa?
That's right.
Okay then. The thing is, Ehara-san and Mamiya are connected. It is kind of loose, but it's there. They have one thing in common.
What?
In both of their pasts, someone they knew was bullied to the point of attempting or committing suicide. Ehara-san lost his son, Toshiro-kun, and as for Yui Mamiya, it's her classmate, Mitsuru Kusumoto. That could be a factor, especially for Mamiya. It's possible that Ehara-san would be a sympathetic figure to her. Maybe enough to help construct an alibi for his revenge. It's possible she only played the part of a groping victim. What do you think? Does it have any merit, or is my theory full of holes?
Even if you're on the right track...
Sawa-sensei? We're just waiting on you to start the staff meeting.
Oh, sorry, I'll be right there.
What happened 13 years ago at Kurokawa? That might be the last piece of the puzzle. What about Yui Mamiya? How'd she react when Mitsuru Kusumoto tried to kill himself by jumping off that roof?
I'm sorry, I'm already late for my meeting.
I'm trying to ask you about a murder here. To Ehara, every unanswered question is a victory for that man. He's only a step away from walking for it. And I know Mamiya had other conspirators. It took more than one person to murder Mikoshiba. They're still at large, even as we speak. I'll be honest. I came here today with a suspicion that you might be more involved in this murder than you're letting on.
A suspicion?
Nothing you've said has made me feel any better about it.
And what should I do about that, huh?
I just want you to tell me, how are Ehara-san and Mamiya connected beyond what I've already figured out? I think you have the key to that answer, even if you don't know that you're the one holding it. It's like a lock, and until I figure out how to get through it, I'm gonna keep picking at it.
I told you, I'm late for a meeting.
I'll be here when you get back. Have a good meeting.
Suit yourself.
comes back. Roll combat roll.
Hey, Sari-san, it's Yagami.
Hey, did you manage to talk to Sawa-sensei?
Yeah, turns out she really was in Mamiya's class. And they were both aware of the suicide incident with their classmate.
Good to know. While we're on the topic, Hoshino-kun got his hands on some new info.
Let's hear it.
The bully at Kurokawa High was named Shinya Kawai. He transferred out right after Mitsuru-kun jumped, as if he were running away. Once he came of age, it looks like he worked here in Kamurocho.
Wow. You really can find a lot online.
Yes, and to top it off, Kawai earned a reputation for talking about how he drove a classmate to suicide. Like he's proud of it. Maybe he thought he'd get a laugh in Kamurocho.
Probably would.
Kawai was more or less a Yakuza, though he never swore into it. I just sent you his picture. It was taken 5 years ago.
What? This guy?
You recognize him?
Not too long ago, some RK punks came asking his whereabouts. Said he was a girls' bar manager who went missing.
Yeah, it looks like he did work at a girls' bar. But we don't know which one.
Okay, so the guy's definitely suspicious. What business would RK have with him?
Do you know if they ever found him?
No. But their leader, Soma, said something about Kawai having already been killed. Like he just vanished from Kamurocho a few years ago, and that was it.
Wait, he was killed?
Uh-huh. Kinda gives me deja vu now that I think about it. Here you have Kawai and Mikoshiba, two known school bullies. And they both end up murder victims?
That could be for a number of reasons. It's not rare for people to disappear in Kamurocho. Usually the trouble is money or women. Maybe that was the case for Kawai.
Could be.
Okay. We'll investigate Kawai a bit more on our end. With RK asking around, word on the street will be loud enough to hear.
How was it, Sari-san? What did Yagami-san have to say?
He said he recently ran into some RK members looking for Shinya Kawai.
Did he?
He also said RK later told him Kawai had been killed.
This is getting scarier with every new lead.
Now that you mention it, I have seen people getting stopped and asked about someone all over town. But if those were RK on the hunt for Kawai, could it have something to do with our case as well?
I'm honestly not sure how RK could be involved in all this. I'm going out for a bit, Hoshino-kun. Do me a favor and keep digging up what you can on Kawai.
Wait, what?
Sometimes you have to get out in the field. It can't just be Yagami-san all the time.
Let me out the window, please.
You don't mean you're going straight to RK for some answers?
What else would I be doing? I need to know why they were looking for Kawai.
Then I'm coming with. I can't just let you do that alone.
Don't worry. It's still light out, and I plan on staying in the open. Besides, if I'm alone, they'll be more eager to talk.
That may be, but still, I'll just call you about every 10 minutes then. For your safety.
I find that rather unnecessary.
You sure?
Let me go. Cowards.
Oh, is that Sari-chan I see? To what do I owe this pleasure?
Nice to see you too.
Oh, hi. Say, aren't you one of Tok's lawyer friends? Does that mean he's on his way too?
It's just me today.
Fine by me. That means you and I get some girl talk time.
Oh, that stings, Mari. And here I thought I had a place in your heart.
Well, no one knows a lady's heart like a bartender. I guess you can stay.
Let's see.
All these bottles got you feeling lost? Care for a few pours from Tox? It'll be our secret. Besides, a man with his tab can't complain.
You're too kind. So I'm actually here to ask you, how can I set up a meeting with RK?
Darn. So this wasn't a pleasure call? Well, I'm glad you're at least enjoying the drink.
True. And looking fancy doing it.
Oh, please. You two are going to embarrass me.
My apologies. I suppose being surrounded by such beauties has a timeless appeal, even at my age.
I'll second that. Masuda here is looking at least a year younger.
Was that supposed to be a compliment?
Of course. If you got any younger, you'd be much too handsome. What's a girl to say?
And I'll second that.
Anyhow, if you're after an RK rendezvous, the good news is those guys are everywhere. But it's not like a civilian can just stroll up and ask, "Hey, are you RK?" and expect to get an answer.
You got that right. And Saori-chan needs to ask them something that's kind of sensitive. Oh, that's certainly going to make things challenging.
Just a bit, yeah.
So I say, why not let the boys do the chasing? Wouldn't be hard for an enchantress like you. But honey, we need to do something about your look. Some nice clothes and a little makeup, and you'd be unstoppable.
Finally. My turn to second something.
I suppose I would need to look approachable.
Tok told me once that if you ever felt like it, Saori-chan, you could put every hostess in Kamurocho to shame. I've gotta admit, I'm curious.
Well, a good hawk hides her talons.
You're saying I should dress like a hostess for this?
Well, I'm sure there are other ways. But if you want a foolproof plan to snag an RK, you've got one.
Oh, if you want, I can get you some looks, and you can choose what you like.
I get the message. And I suppose I'll take you up on that.
Okay, then leave the rest to me.
I don't care. Anything ridiculous.
Would you look at that? Tok was right on the money. I couldn't have imagined.
You sure about that, Mari-san? I hardly feel comfortable wearing this in front of you.
What are you saying? You're so pretty.
I wouldn't say so.
Really?
You're
dynamite. Though, there is one thing that's missing.
What's that?
Pride. That's the final touch you need. Pride in your own beauty.
Well, I'm not sure I have that.
Then how about your pride as a lawyer? You have that, don't you?
As a lawyer?
Yes, there it is. Go ahead and take a look. Now that's the face of a girl who gets the man she wants.
It's been a while since I've felt this way. I have you to thank for that.
These bad boys won't know what hit them. Now, Let's go dangle the bait.
You mean us, right?
You bet. Two nightlife girls like us alone on the street literally brings the RK boys running. Especially along Senryo Avenue. Why don't we take a walk?
Are you sure? I don't want to drag you into this.
Are you kidding? And miss the chance to see this makeover in action? But really, I want you to succeed. I promise I won't be a bother.
Excuse me, ladies. You, get lost on the way to the beauty pageant?
We're already out for a drink. Maybe heading to work somewhere in town?
Oh, we're just two girls bar hopping by our lonesome. Isn't that right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, in that case, why don't you roll with us? I know a great place. You could drink all you want.
Wow, you guys loaded or something? We can throw them back, you know. You sure?
Hell yeah! There's a place my buddy runs. I'd be thrilled to see some ladies like you.
You rugged boys are just my type, actually. But are you really that into older girls?
Me? I'm your type for real?
Oh, what happened to your nose? That bandage makes you look so tough and masculine. What's gotten into me? I am such a mess tonight.
One too many, Saori-chan?
Don't worry, Saori-chan. I love a hot mess. I'm one myself.
That one just asked him outright.
You know, I think you guys may have caught me at the perfect time. What I'm saying is, tonight, I want to take a trip on the wild side.
Oh, yeah? Talk to me, baby.
There's this guy in my life, a real choir boy. And being with him's got me feeling so repressed. Now, I know I should behave like a good girl. But I figure I owe it to myself to cut loose every now and again.
Oh, you never told me that, Saori-chan.
Damn, girl. I'll get loose with you.
Yeah!
Thing is, we all know the biggest party people in town are RK. I heard they can really spice things up, you know?
But Saori-chan, why limit yourself to RK? I think these boys are plenty attractive.
I'm starting to think we were meant for each other.
Oh? What makes you say that?
Wait! Don't tell me you're...
Not supposed to be blurting it out, but yeah. We're RK. And pretty high up, too.
Shoot. RK wouldn't be what it is now without us. Never thought it'd get this big, either.
RK has Komurocho pretty much wrapped around its finger now, huh?
Just about. The time of the Yakuza laying down the law is over. All that respect and chivalry shit. Dead, like all the old legends. Now the underground world is a jungle. Winning the fight's all that matters.
Wow, must be hard. But I think that's hot.
That reminds me. Weren't you RK guys looking for someone recently? A man who disappeared a few years ago?
Oh yeah, him.
We were looking for this dude who ran a girl's bar.
See? I knew you guys would know what that's about.
Well, 5 years ago, he suddenly disappeared. But that's not even news in Kamurocho.
That's so crazy, though. What happened to him? You ever end up finding the guy?
Nah, didn't work out. No surprise, he was just a punk anyway. Name was Kawhi. The way I heard it, some of his old friends rolled up on him one night. My guess is, it was trouble from another town catching up to him. Anyway, they argue for a bit, and it ends with the guy getting shoved into a van. And that's the last time anyone saw the dude.
Whoa, what do you think happened?
I'm thinking they bumped him off. If he was still breathing, he'd be back by now. I heard he never even picked up his final paycheck. My guess, he's fish food now. Or they buried him on some remote-ass mountain.
You have any idea who would have done that to him?
Don't know. They say it was 10 or so people. Young, both men and women. Doesn't sound like a gang thing. But who knows, right? It was 5 years ago.
But if you heard all that, there must have been witnesses, right? So you're saying someone actually saw him get shoved in a van?
Yep. Some chick working at his bar saw it all go down. At least that's what we heard from a guy who heard it from that chick.
Where is this bar anyway?
You mean some random dive bar half a decade ago? Who the hell knows? 100 places have sprung up and gone under since.
But then, why would anyone be looking for Shinya Kawhi now? Someone ask RK to find him? Think that's right?
Hell if I know. It's a question for the top of the food chain. But hold on a sec. Can I ask you something?
Huh?
Just a minute ago, you mentioned a Shinya Kawhi. How'd you know his full name when we never told you?
Oh, shit!
You're only talking to us because you wanted dirt on Kawhi. So who the hell are you?
What do you think you're doing?
Who sent you?
I wouldn't even give you my name. Now let go. Threats and violence aren't going to work on me.
Oh, what have we here? Got ourselves a bad bitch all of a sudden. Too bad she can't keep her hand from shaking.
That's just the excitement talking.
Big talk for a chick dressed to the nines to get info. Huh? Sorry, Chan?
Yeah. Don't even try to fuck with us, lady!
Sorry, Chan!
Huh? What the... Ah!
Beat it, punk.
Higashi-san!
Asshole!
I swear, these jerks are popping up like roaches. No thanks needed. Just be careful on your own. Especially when you're beautiful.
Thank you so much, Higashi-san.
I just said you don't... Wait. How'd you know my name?
It's me, Shirosaki, from Genda Law Office. It's been a while.
Holy shit! No way!
Man, I didn't realize... Shirosaki-sensei. I didn't recognize you. You look incredible.
You're the one who is incredible. This is all my fault. I was the one who put Mari-san in danger. You really saved us.
Young, strong, handsome. That's 3 out of 3 for me.
Those guys were RK. Town's practically overrun with them these days. Like, I can escort you somewhere safe. I got nothing but time on my hands.
Oh, you don't say. Perfect. Who says we can't still salvage some fun out of tonight?
Oh, before we do that, let me call Yagami-san.
Yagami's still a jackass, I see. When Shirasaki-sensei calls, you pick up in two rings.
It is strange that he's not picking up. I'll try again.
Wait, he was killed?
Uh-huh. Kinda gives me deja vu now that I think about it. Here you have Kawai and Mikoshiba, two known school bullies, and they both end up murder victims?
That could be for a number of reasons. It's not rare for people to disappear in Kamurocho. Usually the trouble is money or women. Maybe that was the case for Kawai.
Could be.
Okay. We'll investigate Kawai a bit more on our end. With RK asking around, word on the street will be loud enough to hear.
All right, thanks.
Yagami-san.
Yeah.
Yagami-san.
I guess so.
I'm sorry.
By the way.
Yes. Well...
Oh.
In other words...
So, to sum it up...
No.
Unbelievable.
No.
Huh.
Yes.
I see.
Hey!
He doesn't know what a hooligan is in high school. Isn't that the definition of the word hooligan?
Right.
Well... If I were to guess... Yes. Yes.
understand.
Now that you mention it. No.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Thank you very much.
Does that mean? Huh?
Yes.
He got another job at a school after injuring students at a previous school?
Well.
What? Seriously?
That being said... No. Guess.
Hey.
No. Yes.
What was that? Seriously?
Yagami-san. Yes.
I see. Gotcha.
Please and thank you.
Let's talk to her again. So I'll talk to you when I get back. I'm gonna take a minute.